Everyone to the conference call. All lines have been placed on mute to prevent any background noise. After the speaker's remarks, there will be a question and answer session. If you'd like to ask a question during this time, simply press star, then the number one on your telephone keypad. If you'd like to withdraw your question, press the pound key. Thank you. Mr. Hunter, you may begin your call.
Thank you. This is Jim Hunter with the World Series of Fighting in Las Vegas. Good afternoon and good morning to you, ladies and gentlemen of the media, and we thank you for participating in this conference call, which, of course, is for the inaugural fight card of the World Series of Fighting. It will take place Saturday, November 3 at Planet Hollywood in Las Vegas in the 7,000-seat PH Live venue. It's an 11-bout card. It's going to be televised live on NBC Sports Network starting at 7:30 Pacific and 10:30 Eastern. That is one of the significance of this card, the World Series of Fighting, in its inaugural presentation. Not only does it have NBC Sports Network behind it, but it has Caesars Entertainment, the owners of Planet Hollywood, with it as well. Quite a feat, quite an accomplishment for a first-time ring sport promotion. Getting to the card, there will be four fights that are going to be televised. The first fight will be a Tyrone Spong against Travis Bartlett. Second will be Miguel Torres against Marlon Moraes. Third, Anthony Johnson versus DJ Linderman. The fourth will be Andre Arlovski versus Devin Cole. And, of course, the viewing audience will be able to see highlights and or the complete fights of Ronnie Torres versus Brian Cobb and Gregor Gracie versus Tyson Steele. In addition, the World Series of Fighting is going to be streaming the first three bouts on the undercard through SureDog.com. That'll begin at 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific. That, of course, will feature David Branch versus Dustin Jacoby, JC Cavalcante versus TJ O'Brien, and Gerald Harris versus Josh Berkman. We have five individuals here ready for your questions. Before we start that, please allow me to introduce them. And I referred to the importance of World Series of Fighting in their first card, being televised by NBC Sports, the major network, of course, and having an ongoing affiliation not only with that, but with one of the premier hotel casino operators in the world, if not just in Las Vegas, Caesars Entertainment. But let me suggest that probably the biggest asset that the World Series of Fighting has, the one individual that will make this promotion rise to the top, and that is a gentleman we all know, a six-time world kickboxing champion, a ring legend, an icon in ring sports, the president of the World Series of Fighting, Mr. Ray Sefo.
Ray, hi, everybody.
Want to say a couple of words here?
Just thank you so much for all the love and support from the media and everybody out there. And, of course, you know, this wouldn't be possible without the fighters that we have on this card, so I want to thank the fighters again because, you know, without you guys, none of this would be possible. So thank you.
Thank you, Ray. Another gentleman we have on the call, of course, will be in the main event. That is former UFC heavyweight champion Andre Arlovski. Andre, a couple of comments, please.
Hello, everyone. Thank you, World of Series of Fighting, for the opportunity to be a part of your family. I'm very excited. I'm looking forward to face Devin Cole November 3rd. Thank you.
Thank you, Andre. Next up is the gentleman that's going to be taking on Andre. He is a former IFL star and a rugged competitor, Mr. Devin Cole.
Hi. I just want to thank everybody for having me on here. Thank World Series of Fighting, everybody involved, for treating us so good and putting us together and giving us the opportunity. And I'm really excited for this fight with Andre. It's going to be fun.
Thank you, Devin. Next gentleman standing by is in the co-main event. is the hard-hitting Anthony Johnson.
Hey, I just want to say thank you for having me here. I'm excited about the new promotion World Series of Fighting, and I'm excited about my fight with DJ Linderman, and I think this promotion is going to go really far, and I'm glad to be a part of it.
Thank you, Anthony. And the last gentleman to whom Anthony is referred, Anthony's looking forward to fighting him. I'm sure this gentleman is looking forward to meeting Anthony as well. That's Mr. DJ Linderman.
Hi, everybody. I just want to say thank you to the World Series Fighting for bringing me in on a big fight like this to be able to show the world what I can do. And thank you again.
Thank you, DJ. Operator, if we could open it up for questions now, please.
Once again, if you'd like to ask a question, please press star 1 on your telephone keypad. That's star and the number 1. Our first question comes from the line of Steven Morocco with MMAJunkie.com.
Great. Great. And your question is...
I'm sorry.
Go ahead, please.
Did I interrupt?
No.
Okay, sorry about that. Hey, question for Andre. Are you fighting Jeff Monson at Royal FC on February 2nd? Is that accurate?
You know what? To be honest with you, I don't really know. It's my manager holds all this my for fights, but I know for sure I'm going to face Dayan Cole in November, so, and I focus right now on those fights.
Okay. Yeah, the reason why I wanted to ask is because it seems like your career is getting a lot busier as of late, and I was wondering if you could sort of talk about that, if you feel if you're trying to fight a lot more than if you're trying to sort of up your schedule and fight a lot more, and where you feel you're at this point in your career.
Definitely I want to stay busy, and for me it's the best case scenario to fight 4 or 5 times a year, and like I said, I really appreciate for that opportunity to face in Dayan Cole in November, so the World Series of Fighting, and because I had like some problem when I was under contract with UFC, I didn't fight pretty much, didn't fight for 11 months. I had some personal issues, you know, I didn't fight for a long time till now. I want to stay busy and I want to fight, and I feel great, and I have right now right people, right trainers, right place to train, and I'm very excited, and I'm just ready to fight. You know, I'm like Nike, just do it.
And then for Devin, if I could, can you talk about the opportunity about fighting an ex-UFC champ like Andre and what this means to your career?
First off, it's an honor. I mean, being able to fight anybody his level, and you know, I think I'm the best fighter I've ever been. I'm down in the American Top Team right now. I've been down here for 8 weeks, and I think this is going to be the best fight I've ever had. I feel the best I ever have, virtually injury-free, best shape of my life, and you know, I'm ready for the best. Andre, you know, he's had a couple good fights, you know, last year, and you know, he's back on track, and I'm really, really looking forward to it. I think it's going to be a good chance to showcase my talents.
Does it mean anything more for you, given the sort of stutter step that you had a little bit early in your career with the near signing, well, I guess with the signing with the, or near signing with the UFC?
Yeah, it does. That was definitely a letdown. But, you know, everything happens for a reason. And you know, when World Series of Fighting contacted me, you know, I jumped on it. I'm excited to be, you know, the main event, the very first card. That must show right there that they have some respect for me, and because they're going to want a good fight in their first main event. And so I'm really excited about that, because it must show that they have some respect for me. So.
And then one more, if I could, for Ray. Is there any thought about putting a belt on the line for any of these guys?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's something we definitely have discussed with the team, and I think we'll look at doing, you know, setting up bouts by our third or fourth event. By then we would have, you know, the guys competed several times and look at crowning a champion.
Okay, thank you very much, guys.
Thank you.
Our next question comes from the line of Dale D'Souza with at the MMA Corner.
Thanks, everybody. Question for Ray. Ray, can you talk about how you're feeling about holding this event in Las Vegas?
Super excited, nervous. It's the whole thing is putting this whole card together and the time that's allowed us to put it together. I think we've done a lot of learning along the way. So, we're very confident, and especially with the all the guys. I mean, you just got to look at the card, and we're very thankful that we have the guys that we have. And to come out on top as a first event with NBC Sports Network as well as Caesars Entertainment Group and the production teams that we have, the team that we have in the office, I'm very confident we're going to do a good job. And, of course, we just like anything, it's like stepping in that cage. It's a bit of nerves, but, that's what keeps you sharp. So I'm excited about it.
All right, excellent. And then a question for Anthony, if I may. I mean, Anthony, similar question. Just your thoughts on this fight with DJ Linderman.
Well, I think the fight is going to be awesome. DJ is a great competitor. He's really, really tough. He has a great team. So, anytime you have a fight in Vegas, just with the atmosphere around Vegas and in the arena, you're going to have a good time. So, I'm looking forward to it.
And finally, DJ, thoughts on fighting Anthony?
I appreciate the fight with Anthony. He's a great fighter. I'm just here to prove that I belong in the same category as him. He's a top 20 fighter in the world, and I'm glad they're giving me the chance to be able to fight him in front of the world.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Our next question comes from the line of Matt Manzella with CageReligion.com.
Good afternoon, guys. Thanks for taking the time on this call. This one's for Andre. Andre, you've kind of bounced around in your career since leaving Strikeforce. I mean, we saw you in Pro Elite, 1FC, possibly talks at Royal FC this February. But do you plan on making the World Series of Fighting your home, or are you kind of leaving your options open at this point?
Like I said, I really appreciate the World Series of Fighting for that opportunity to fight on the card on first event in Vegas. It was a while when I'm going to fight in Vegas last time. I fought probably six years ago. And, for me, it's more important right now that the World Series of Fighting gave me that opportunity to rebuild my MMA career, I'll try to put a good show if they're going to be interested to keep me fighting for World Series of Fighting. Of course, I will. Just like great opportunity for me. I want to show my skills. I will try to put a great performance, and that's it. I just want to fight.
Right, thanks a lot, Andre. A quick one for Ray. Ray, I know it's obviously early to say, but are there any kind of concrete plans in the works for a second show?
Yes. I mean, we're really discussing that, and obviously, our team and NBC Sports are going to sit back after this first event and discuss the further shows. Already, we're looking at the end of January for the second show. So, yeah, there's definitely concrete discussions on when the next event will be.
All right, thanks a lot, Ray. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Our next question comes from the line of Eddie Goldman with No Holds Barred.
Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. First question for Andre. Andre, following your career for a number of years, you were at the top of the heavyweight division. Then you suffered a bunch of losses. And then now, more recently, you've come back with a lot of impressive performances and wins. And, the most recent fight with Tim Sylvia, technically he wasn't a win, but you should have gotten the win. Can you talk about a little bit of that, what your career is in sort of revival, what's led to you being able to get back on the path of winning and revive your career?
Like I said, I choose what's more important for me.
and I came to Albuquerque, New Mexico, and trained with Mike Jackson. All my camps in Albuquerque, I'm training for this fight in Albuquerque against Darren Cola. Great trainers here, great sparring partners, you know, and like I said, I choose what's more important for me. And I think if I came here after my fight against Emelianenko in 2009, right now it might be a different story, but everything happened for the reason, you know, and like I said, I'm still young, I still have energy, I want to be a champion again, I want to climb back on the top, so I would do everything possible to do this, and this is a great opportunity for me to prove everyone, prove myself that I'm not done yet, and thank you again, WLS. So, World Series of Fighting for this opportunity to face Darren Cole, he's a top fighter, you know, he's not back down. I think it's going to be a very interesting match for MMA fans. Thank you very much again.
Do you expect to mainly try to keep this fight standing since Devin Cole is known to have a background as a wrestler, or will you just see how it goes?
He's a great wrestler, and I saw his fight against Daniel Cormier. He did very well, and of course I have to pay attention for his wrestling skills. That's why I train here. I have great wrestlers here too, but we'll see. Everybody likes chaos, you know. I will try and knock him out, and I'm sure Darren will do everything possible to kick my ass too, and kick knock my ass out too. So it's going to be, like I said, a very interesting fight. I'm sure he trained hard for this fight. I trained hard for this fight, and I'm just ready to go. Very excited. I don't know. The fight will show. It's going to be on the ground or standing. I don't know. I'm sure that Darren is ready to strike with me. I'm ready to wrestle the single seat.
And it's a similar question to Devin. Devin, is there a preference for you? Would you rather this, you know, this to be more grappling, or are you prepared if the fight stays mainly on the feet?
Well, you know, like Andre said, I've prepared all ways, you know. I think everybody always has a route that they go to, you know, what got them to the point. You know, I'm not saying I'm going to go out there and look for the takedown. But I think a wrestler more looks for a takedown than standing up. You know, a stand-up guy tries to keep it standing. You know, I'm ready for all aspects. So, of course, Andre, you know, is known for standing more. So I've prepared more for the standing game. So, you know, I'm ready for wherever it goes. You know, it's mixed martial arts. I can't say, you know, it's going to go here, it's going to go there. It's going to, you know, it's going to go where the fight goes. You know, might go out there and he does one thing, which makes me do another and changes everything around. I don't really have a set game plan when I go in. I try and be ready for all aspects, and I'm the most prepared I ever have been right now. So,
a lot of people have discussed which discipline is the best single one as a foundation for mixed martial arts. Do you think wrestling is the best foundation, or that there are a lot of them that are equal to wrestling?
I think starting off, you know, 7, 8, 10 years ago, it was just because you could learn how to take less damage being a wrestler. You know, you learn how to stay out of submissions and you could control someone and you would be able to take less damage and therefore, you know, grind out the win. But I think nowadays it's the sports evolved so much that I think people are going to look back at this generation before us and say everybody's well-rounded, because the up-and-coming fighters and fighters nowadays, they're not wrestlers, they're not boxers, they're not submission artists, they're mixed martial artists. And you know, I'm really excited to be involved on this evolution per se of the sport. It's really great.
All right, thanks, and good luck to everybody November 3rd.
Our next question comes from the line of Mike Chiappetta with MMAfighting.com.
Anthony, please. Anthony, after you parted ways with the UFC, I'm pretty sure I remember you saying that, you know, your goal was to eventually end back there. And coming out to the World Series of Fighting, from what they released, that you signed an exclusive contract with them. And I'm just kind of wondering, you know, how did they convince you that they were the right fit for you, and how did you determine that that was the case?
Well, overall, you know, my coaches and my management, my managers and stuff, they sat down and talked with me and just told me to sit back and think about things and, you know, thought about the pros and cons of, you know, the situation that I was in. And, I mean, I chose World Series of Fighting, and one big reason why I chose World Series of Fighting is because the people that are running this organization have been through what I've been through, you know, with being a fighter and stuff like that. So they know how it is inside the cage and outside the cage. So they really understand us as fighters. And, you know, I really like Ray a lot. I've been watching him since his kickboxing days. So that really motivated me, you know, to work with a guy like him. And he's a great guy. So he helped out a lot with my decision.
Was it a difficult decision to come to in terms of locking yourself into an exclusive deal, or did it just kind of make sense after a little while thinking about it?
It just kind of made sense, you know.
All right, cool. And question for Ray. You know, in putting together your first event here, has it been harder than expected, easier than expected, somewhere in between?
Like I said earlier, you know, this is taking us almost 2 years to put together. And, you know, just like anything, when you start something, obviously you want to start slow. And, you know, we've overcome some bumps along the way, and I think those bumps became a blessing in disguise because we were able to sit back and, you know, reflect on what needed to change and so on. And then, you know, when things started falling in place, I think the stars were aligned for us to have the guys that we have, you know, it's amazing. And then again, I said, you know, we feel the team and myself feel very blessed to have the car that we have because, you know, at the end of the day, nothing is possible without these guys. And you know, being a fighter, it's just a blessing. Like I said, you know, my job is to make sure that these guys are looked after and that we put on a great show.
Okay, and early on the call, the gentleman who started the call, I think his name was Jim Hunter, said that the venue holds about 7,000 people. Is that exactly what's going to be configured for, 7,000?
I believe so. It could be a little bit less, but it wouldn't be much less than that.
Yeah, and are you expecting a sellout?
Yes, the tickets are going great at the moment. So, you know, thanks to the hard work of our team as well as our, you know, partners, and so... Yeah, you know, we're very pleased with the way things are moving right now.
Okay, great. Thanks very much, guys. Good luck to you.
Thank you. Let me, Jim Hunter here, let me interject on that question on the venue. The configuration is fairly set. It is a permanent seat facility, so we didn't decide on 5,000, 6,000, 7,000, 8,000. It is an approximately a 7,000-seat venue, and we felt that that's the crowd we're going to get. So no sense starting small if we're going to be able to fill it up with the quality bouts that we have on it. So it is a fixed seat venue, the PH Live is.
Our next question comes from the line of Michael Stets with thefightnerd.com.
Yeah, thank you. Question for Anthony Johnson. In regard to your weight issues in the past from welterweight, and you missed weight with Belfort when you were going to move to middleweight, do you feel the most comfortable at light heavy? And have you kicked yourself at all for not fighting at light heavy to begin with?
Well, I definitely haven't, you know, kicked myself for not fighting at light heavy. You know, I'm glad that I've, you know, with my career so far, even though I had ups and downs, you know, I don't take anything back. It's just a learning process from the mistakes that I've made in the past. But fighting at 205 has been a blessing, you know. You never see me smiling the day of weighing. I'm usually, like, mad at the world and don't want to talk to anybody, don't want anybody to touch me. I just want to step on the scale and then start eating right after. But now I'm more calm, I'm more relaxed, and I just go with the flow now when it comes down to making weight.
And have you had way more energy in the fight night in the cage?
Yeah, of course. I can eat pretty much whatever I want. Usually the day of weigh-in, I have like 2 pounds to drop, and that's it. So life is great for me right now.
Thanks.
Okay.
Our next question comes from the line of Matthew Roth, Bleacher Report.
Yes, I have two questions for Ray. Ray, earlier this week it was announced that that you have Bosch Rutten and Todd Harris as the announcers. Can you speak a little bit to what the decision was to have those two as your announce team?
Sorry, ask that question again.
Sorry about that. Earlier this week, it was announced that that Bosch Rutten and Todd Harris would be your announce team. Can you speak a little bit to what caused that decision or what made your decision to have Bosch and Todd in the announcement?
Yeah, after, you know, our team and NBC Sports sat down and discussed, you know, we came to a conclusion that we were going to have a two-man team instead of a three-man team. And, you know, Todd Harris has a lot of experience in anchoring fights and calling fights. And so, you know, Bosch Rutten, what can you say about that guy? I mean, he's truly a legend in the sport. So that was a team decision, and that's the team for now.
Okay. And can you speak a little bit to the expectations for this first event now that the Strikeforce card with Daniel Cormier is no longer happening?
Well, yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, obviously we want everybody to tune in, and the ratings for us, obviously that's something that's really important to us. And, of course, putting on a great show. And with the card that we have, I have no doubt in my mind that all these guys are going to come to perform. I mean, I've seen all these guys fight before, and they're, some of the best in the world. So we're very fortunate to have all these guys on the card.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Our next question comes from the line of Joshua Carey with MMADiehard.com.
Yes, first question for Anthony Rumble Johnson, please. Obviously, this is everyone's World Series, MMA World Series debut here, but you also have a few teammates on the card, definitely on the televised portion with Tyrone Spong, who's, arguably one of the greatest kickboxers to ever compete in that sport, along with Sefo as well. But you get to fight with him on the same night. What's the atmosphere been like in the gym? Obviously, Tyrone's also making his MMA debut the same night as well.
It's been great. You know, we've been pushing each other really hard, and, I train with Tyrone a lot, and we work on, wrestling, and I stand up a ton, and Jay-Z and Fabio, they train with each other a lot. So, I mean, just with this team overall, we help each other out and just help each other grow. So it's not just like, to me, it's not just me, Tyrone, Fabio, and Jay-Z fighting it. To me, it's all of us, the whole Black Zillion clan, just fighting in one night.
Great, thank you. And follow-up to that is each time out, especially since you've departed the UFC here, and definitely whenever you move to 205, you've been more aggressive each time out. Do you feel at home at 205 and with this promotion going forward?
Yeah, I definitely feel at home. I think 205 is where I need to be. And, World Series of Fighting, I just think this is going to be the next best thing around right now, you know what I mean? And I'm excited to be a part of it.
And thank you. Now, a little while back you told me that that you feel that the Black Zillions do have the best camp in the world, and that you're more so of a family, than a team. Now you're moving on with the World Series of Fighting here also. How exciting of a time is this for your career?
Oh, it's exciting. I think things are starting to really kick off like they should have been doing a while ago, but, things happen whenever it's supposed to happen, so I'm not worried about anything, and I'm just happy to be in the position that I'm in now.
Thank you, Anthony. That's all I have. If I can ask one final question for Sefo, please. Obviously, this is a new role for you, but how enjoyable and exciting has this process been? It's quite the early accomplishment here to be on NBC Sports, also to have the support of Planet Hollywood and to be hosting your first event there with such great talent that you have on this card.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you. But, again, I couldn't be more happy or excited about where we are. And like Anthony just said, you know, things are meant to happen when they happen. And in this past 2 months, you know, it's like the stars were aligned for us, because to have the guy that we have on the card, again, like, I can't, you know, say enough about these guys. They're some of the best in the world. And to have them on our card and to kick off Wizards of Fighting with NBC Sports as well as Caesars Entertainment Group, you know, I feel very blessed and very happy to be where we are.
Thank you very much, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Operator, let me interject a question here. We've heard from Anthony, and the gentleman justifiably emotes confidence, but the gentleman who he's meeting, DJ Linderman, has got to be confident, too. He has a three-fight win streak. DJ, could you address how you feel going into this fight, coming on a three-fight win streak? Is that boosting your confidence, or is it added pressure, meaning having that streak on the line?
Oh, no, I've had the streak before. I went five, and then Mr. Devin Cole broke that streak before. And I feel confident as much as I can be. I'm at the top of my game, I feel, right now. I'm injury-free. I'm feeling 110% right now. There hasn't been a fight. I have been probably 110% that I could think of, you know. I feel great that I could fight Anthony Johnson, and there's no pressure to it. I come into every fight relaxed. I'm going to come in there, and I'm going to be aggressive, more aggressive than Anthony, and it's going to be a great fight between us two.
Thank you, DJ. Operator, any got some more questions?
Our next question comes from the line of Steve Juan with AngryMarks.com.
Thank you, Operator. My first question is for Ray. Obviously, the World Series of Fighting is off to a great start with the relationship with NBC Sports and all the great fighters we have on the line today, but it's also entering a field of very heavy competition with UFC and Bellator and other organizations. So how does the World Series of Fighting plan to combat the competitiveness in the field that they're in?
We're really happy with where we are today. We're not in competition with anybody. We're in competition with ourselves. Obviously, our goal is to try and be the best that we can be. Again, I go back to the fight card that we have. We have some of the best fighters in the world on that card. And so for us, we're very happy and very blessed to be where we are right now. And again, we're not trying to compete with anybody. It's obvious that UFC is the best at what they do, and they've done an amazing job to do, to be where they are. And, at the end of the day, without them doing so well, we wouldn't be where we are today as well. So the biggest competition is against ourselves, is to put on the best fights we can put on and for our guys to come down and perform the best they can on the night.
Absolutely. Thank you. And next question is for Devin Cole. Devin, you've been getting nothing but tough competition in MMA. You fought an Olympic wrestler, and now you're fighting a former UFC heavyweight champion. Do you feel this is your biggest challenge to date?
Definitely. This is the first, time I fought anybody with his record, with his accolades. Former UFC champion, you don't get there by accident. And, I have been fighting some tough guys, but, I'm not, when you get to that level, who else are you going to fight? You don't want to go fight, lunch boxes. And to get that next level, you got to beat the best guys. And luckily, I'm getting this opportunity. And when it's all said and done, it's going to be a great thing for me.
And as a follow-up, you've actually fought DJ Linderman twice, and he's on this card with you. So what are your thoughts on DJ Linderman also being on the World Series of Fighting inaugural event with you?
It's pretty cool. We fought twice. We went 1-1. And instead of opting for the rubber match, we only live about 45 miles apart. I live Southern Oregon. He lives Northern California. And, instead of opting for the rubber match, we decided, hey, why don't we just start training together, coming from a small area. It's
really hard to get the training partners that you need. And so we actually, I'm down in Florida right now, but when we're at home, we'll travel the hour each way, one of us usually a week, and, you know, train together. And it's kind of cool, two guys coming from smaller gyms being on this getting this opportunity.
Yeah, it's a great opportunity. And if I can follow up with DJ on that, it's obviously a big event for you, and you're coming in on a 3-fight win streak. But how has training with Devin helped you for the fight? And what is your biggest concern about Rumble Johnson in the cage?
Training with Devin's been great. Having another top 20 fighter in the world by your side, you know, getting his great wrestling knowledge, it helps out greatly. With Anthony, I think he's going to be more dangerous on the feet, and I've cut for that. I've had some great strikers come in and mirror his fighting style, and I think it's going to be a great fight between us, but I'm going to have what it takes to be able to stop his stand-up.
All right, well, that leads to my next question, which is for Rumble Johnson. You've looked like a man on a mission since you left UFC, and obviously you're very renowned for your striking power. Now, DJ says he's got the plan to counter that. How do you respond?
Everybody said that, so I'm used to, you know, people saying that, and he should be that confident and feel that way because he has a great camp, and I'm sure he brought the right guys in to train with him to get ready for me, and I did the same thing with the team that I have, and, you know, I just know it's going to be a great fight. You know, I don't think it's going to be a boring fight from start to finish. I think it's going to be, you know, fireworks from the first second to the end of the fight. You know what I mean? No matter who wins. So this is just a great opportunity for both of us, and I'm excited about it.
All right. Thank you very much, and thank you, operator.
Our next question comes from the line of Jack Bratcher with Pro MMA Now.
Hi. My first question is for Ray. Hi, Ray, how many events do you currently have planned for 2013?
Are you there?
Yeah, can you hear me, Ray?
Well, you know, right now, I mean, obviously, we would like to put on anything from 8 to 12 events a year. But, you know, that's just something that we just got to, again, we're taking one step at a time. You got to crawl before you walk, and, you know, the team and myself have, sat down many a times and discussed this, and it's just one of these things. You just got to take your time with it, and we will be able to confirm things after this event.
And do you want to stay in Vegas there or kind of follow the Strike Force model where you branch out across the country?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, for our first few events, we're going to be at home, which is Vegas, and then I mean, we're getting a lot of requests from all over the country to bring World Series of Fighting, so that's just a matter of time.
Any other states definitely in the playbook?
Well, one of them is New Jersey, for example. You know, there's a lot of interest from all over the country, to be honest.
Okay, thank you very much. My next question was for Andre.
Yeah.
Andre, I saw your one of your video blogs there. Did you ever get up on the high dive?
No, I just recently learned how to swim, you know, and yeah. The best of my swimming coach is like so mean to me, like, but I think this is good, and I really like to work with you, so.
Well, I saw you had some good swimming partners there. The little girls there jumping off the high dive, kind of showing you up a little bit.
Yeah, I was kind of scared to jump from a little of these things, you know, because like it's bouncing so much, and I was scared that piece of wood can like slap me in my face or my ass. So I was a little scared.
All right, thanks so much, and look forward to the fight. That's all I had.
Our next question comes from the line of Zeus King with MMAOpinion.com.uk.
Thank you guys for having me. Congratulations on getting this group of fighters together.
This looks like it's going to be a great event. I'm a big fan of Miguel Torres. Is NBC Sports going to report and cover World Series of Fighting in their sports casts on other shows?
Hello?
Are you there?
Yeah.
I'm assuming this question is being directed to me, right?
Yeah, for Ray, yes.
Okay. yeah, that's a good question. I'm really not sure where, you know, how to answer that question. I think maybe Mike might be able to elaborate a little bit on that.
Let me ask, this is Jim. Let me ask you, what was the question specifically regarding to NBC Sports? You say,
Are they going to be covering, so like during a halftime of you know, another event would
you're talking about the promo events leading up to the event and what happened.
Oh, okay.
That is a, as I think Ray knows better than I, that is a, basically NBC has their programming schedule and where they drop promos in, be it for the be it for our World Series of Fighting event, or perhaps a Monday Night Football event, that is basically an internal decision of how often and within what program content they do. But rest assured, they will be promoting this event because everybody, from World Series of Fighting to NBC to Caesars Entertainment, everybody wants to get the word out and have the viewers tuning in to this inaugural event. So, yes, they will be doing promos. Exactly when and where and how many, that is, NBC has obviously has the more complete answer on that. But, yes, there will be promos.
Excellent. I have a question for Devin Cole. You've been to the distance in your last four fights. You feel that your cardio is going to help try to take Andre Arlovski into deep water, or are you just going to use your cardio to push the pace?
Well, you know, you always got to prepare. I'm ready to go three rounds hard. You know, if something happens within those three rounds at the fight ends, you know, that's a bonus. But, you know, I always, yeah, there's nothing worse than being out of shape and in a fight and, you know, wanting to pick it up that extra gear and you can't. This is the best camp I've ever had, and I actually initially came down to help Bigfoot get ready to fight Travis Brown and started my camp that way, then ended up signing this fight. So this is the best, longest camp I've ever had, and I'm just, you know, peaking perfect time. And, you know, if something happens, it happens, but at the same time, I'm ready for a three-round war, and, you know, that's what I'm banking on. When people say, oh, I'm going to go out and do this, do that, finish its first, second round, you never know what's going to happen. But there's one thing that's going to happen is the fight's going to go the distance, whether it's the you can bank on it going the distance. And if it happens shorter than that, you know, it happens. But I'm ready for three rounds, so.
Excellent. Thank you. For our Andre Arlovski, just kind of building on what you were saying earlier, you've been much more active in the last couple of years, and if not for a weird technicality that they reversed, you definitely won the last fight with Tim Sylvia. Did you like having the ability to throw the soccer kick, or you more established with the unified moves?
First of all, against Tim Sylvia, I thought for some reason the referee gave me the signal. He gave me his permission to throw to kick soccer kick. What's happened? It's okay. I'm not complaining about the result. It's okay. Most important thing is that I shot many mouses who said that Arlovski has a weak chin, glass chin, this and that. Tim Sylvia, he landed a couple good right hands, and actually he hurt me in the end of the first round, you know, and I survived. And I'm very happy about that. I like to be active, you're right. I want to fight as often as possible. About what Devin says, fight might go to the distance. Yeah, absolutely agree with him because I run 1 mile a little bit more, 5 minutes too, so, and it's gonna be like a little bit stupid from my side to think that I might finish him in the first or second round. If I will, it's perfect for me, but if not, I'm ready for going for 15 minutes war, and I really appreciate all my sparring partners for help, and actually I wanna go like 3 rounds with Devin, you know.
Okay, and if I could ask DJ Linderman, since you have split one-on-one with Devin Cole, has Andre come and ask you for any pointers on how to fight him?
No questions there. I actually thought about going down to Jackson's for a camp, but just to get a little bit of diversity down there, but then I heard Andre was there, and so it wouldn't have been a good idea since me and Devin trained together.
There you go. All right, well, thank you guys very much. Best of luck, and Rumble, you've looked excellent in your last several fights, and just keep it up, man. Thank you very much.
Operator Jim Hunter, let me just clarify. I did misspeak about a minute ago when I mentioned Monday Night Football, which, of course, is on ESPN, NBC, Terrestrial Network does Monday or Sunday Night Football. So just so we're clear on that. Thank you.
The next question comes from the line of David Maiero with Nux.
Yes, hello. How's everybody doing today? My question is for Ray. I got a couple questions, the first of which is, Ray, how do you guys plan on awarding the title? Do you guys plan on doing a tournament format, or how do you guys plan on handling that?
Well, right now, you know, obviously for us, it's our goal in terms of running a tournament, which will happen at some point in sometime in the future. But, you know, our goal right now is just creating a roster of good fighters. In terms of individual titles, that's something that we got to look at after this fight, and probably, like I said earlier, it'll probably take three events to kind of see who's at the top of the league and look at crowning a champion.
Okay. And then going on the whole thing, you know, I mean, Strikeforce canceled the second event. A lot of people believe that Strikeforce will be going away soon. Are you guys going to try to take that opportunity to fill that void and become the bigger promotion, you know what I mean, next to UFC and fill the void that Strikeforce will eventually leave?
You know, for us, is, I mean, that would be great. And obviously that's our goal, is to try and be, you know, one of the forces in the world of mixed martial arts. I feel for the guys who was on that last card for Strikeforce, because, you know, being a fighter and having these guys, that's how these guys make their living. And for the card to be canceled, obviously I feel for the fighters. You know, again, it's a great opportunity for us, because we're going to be the only show on that night. And, you know, we're looking to do a lot of big things.
Okay, yeah, sounds great. We look forward, you know what I mean, we plan on being there, we look forward to everything. Just one last question. As far as women's MMA, if and when Strikeforce does go away, all that's left is Invicta, you know what I mean, unless the UFC wants to bring in a women's division. Do you guys plan on the women's division, or has that anything you've thought of or talked about?
No, we haven't really discussed that. You know, again, the team and myself have been really, you know, flat out with just putting everything together and focusing on this event, November 3rd. And so, you know, that's obviously another topic that we've probably discussed in the near future.
Okay. All right. Well, again, David Nieto with Max.com. I appreciate you guys. Look forward to seeing you guys next Saturday. Good luck with your first event, and I wish you many more.
Thank you so much.
Next question is from the line of Heidi Fang with MMA Fighter Fight Corner.
Yes, my first question is for DJ Linderman. You've bounced around a little bit from light heavyweight and heavyweight. Do you feel comfortable at light heavyweight, and do you think it gives you an advantage in this fight?
Oh, definitely. It gives me advantage. I mean, I'm used to the bigger, stronger guys, but being down at 205, I'm a whole lot quicker. And putting those two things together, it's dangerous for a guy to go against, you know, power and or speed and strength. So there's going to be some advantages to it, and there's going to be advantages for Anthony. He's been down lower than I have, so he's going to have a little quickness to him. And I just think it's going to be a great fight between us, and we're both going to have our advantages.
Thank you. For Devin, you're 7-2 in your last 9 fights. What do you attest your remarkable return to?
Really, I think it was just refocusing. A lot of it has to do with my family, my wife, my 2 sons. Before, I was just fighting the fight. This way, I'm fighting. I have a purpose, and it's really for them. Everything I do is for them. And, every bout I take, every win will help my family in one way or the other. And, you know, instead of skipping that practice or doing this or doing that, you know, I try and tell myself, you know, well, how is this helping your family? And going, you know, pushing that extra round when nobody does or doing this. So I really think, you know, it's I'm in a better place in my life and, happy with who I am, happy with the people around me and really just looking in both my boys' eyes in the morning. I really think that's what I really think is helping me.
Thank you. And my last question will be for Ray Sefo. You've obviously had a remarkable kickboxing career yourself, and now that you're president of this organization, how much do you feel that angle helps you relate to all of the fighters that you're dealing with on a day-to-day basis in planning for this card?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, the experience I've gained through kickboxing, MMA, boxing, kung fu, obviously it does help a lot with understanding the game, understanding the fighters, understanding what they go through, the sacrifices that they have to do, have to go through. For example, you know, Devin Cole just mentioned about his wife and his kids. You know, I'm sure there are times that he has to go away to camp. And so understanding all those put together, it makes me understand the fight side of things. The business side of things is nothing new to me. Myself and a business partner ran the K1 New Zealand event, which was a success. And so this is, you know, a fun process as well as challenging. But I love it. I love being busy. I love being part of martial arts. Has been my whole life. You know, at 5 years old, I had my first boxing gloves. So to be part of Wizards of Fighting and to be part of these guys' family, if you will, you know, it gives me great honor to, you know, have all these great fighters on the card.
Actually, I do have one last question for you, Ray. The Decagon we had discussed when you first started setting up for the World Series of Fighting, you said it was a little larger than anticipated. Are you going with the original dimensions? And I guess if you could let people know what those dimensions are and the style of the cage that the guys will be fighting in.
Yes, we are going with the Decagon, which is a 10-sided cage, 28 by 28, I believe. We like the look of it. It looks great. I think, you know, at times, I mean, I'm sure that all the guys that's on the line right now will contest to this, that a cage is a cage. And as soon as they jump in that ring, it doesn't really matter. Oh, in that cage, it doesn't really matter what size, how big, how small. Their focus is to get in there and get the job done.
Thank you for your time. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Our next question comes from the line of Tristan Ducross with the Ducross Brothers.
Hey, guys. Thank you for allowing me to join this. This question goes out to Ray Sefo. Ray, what's the story behind World Series of Fighting? How did it come about?
It's been a great process. I go back to a Friday night. I'm getting interviewed by Tap Out Radio with Cookland. We talked about how K1 was going into bankruptcy, She's telling me about how, you know, she's a huge fan of K1, and she would like to see somebody take it over. One of the things I said is, you know, I could do it. And after that interview for myself, I thought of a good friend of mine who's, you know, a wealthy guy, and I thought, well, you know, he'd be the best person to talk to, because I had kind of a passing conversation. I mentioned it to him about a year prior to this, and this was a Friday night. Saturday at 8 o'clock in the morning, I get a phone call from my buddy, and the first thing he says, hey, brother, what are you doing? I'm like, well, I'm heading to strength and conditioning training. And he says, well, what are you doing after that? I said, I guess I'm having breakfast with you. And that was, so when I turned up, we sat down. And I said, what's up, brother? And he's like, you know what? I've been thinking about the last few weeks talking to you about starting a fight league. And it was just super crazy because it's exactly what I wanted to talk to him about. And that was the birth of Versus of Fighting, and here we are.
All right, thank you, Ray. And then this one goes out to the Pitbull. Andre Arlovski, you've won your last three fights, and you have a movie career, and you just released one called The New Universal Soldier, and it has Jean-Claude Van Damme. We've seen Steven Seagal, his success in MMA. Has Jean-Claude Van Damme taught you anything?
No, I know what I'm good. I think I'm going to stick with Mr. Greg Jackson, Uncle John, and my trainer. So no more movie stars in MMA, except Mr. Seagal.
All right. Thank you guys for your time.
Our next question comes from the line of Joshua Carey with MMADieHard.com.
Yes. Another question for Ray Sefo, please. You've got quite a bit of talent on this card. How did you come to the result here of having, you know, Tyrone, Miguel, Anthony, and then obviously Andre and Devin as the main event? But how was the process of narrowing it down to, you know, to those four fights and those eight gentlemen that will be on the main card?
Actually, it's been a great process. In terms of Tyrone, I actually spoke to Tyrone from the very beginning of this because he was already living in the States and was wanting to, you know, he was looking to go into MMA. And so I spoke to him about a year prior to us signing him. And so we were really blessed and happy to have him, you know, as one of our guys on the card. Getting the rest of the team, you know, that was a great job done by our matchmaker, which is Ali Abdeluiz, who's been in the game a very long time. And he and the team have done an amazing job putting this card together with myself. And so, again, I can't thank the guys enough for being part of the family of Versus of Fighting.
Great. Thank you very much, Ray. My final question for the call is for Devin, please. Obviously, this is a big opportunity for yourself, not only fighting Andre, but fighting, as the headliner for the inaugural event here. What were your initial thoughts on fighting Andre, but also headlining in this event as well?
Well, it's really an honor, the way I got to put it is. You know, obviously, World Series of Fighting with their first show, they're going to want to put on a good main event. Andre Arlovski's obviously got a bigger name than me, but for them, they're not going to want to go out there and put on a one-sided fight. And for them to ask me to take that fight, you know, I'm amazed. You know, I'm honored. I'm truly honored to get this opportunity. And you know, when it's all said and done, it's going to do great things for my career. So all I can say is it's really an honor.
Great. Thank you very much, Devin, and best of luck to all you gentlemen and yourself and the organization as well, Ray.
Our last question comes from the line of Steve Julon with AngryMarks.com.
Thank you, operator. I have two questions. The first will go to Andre Arlovski.
previous caller mentioned that your fight with Tim Sylvia was overturned to a no contest. Now, you're obviously not looking past Devin Cole, but if Ray Sefo signed Tim Sylvia, would you want to have that rematch and prove the point that you beat him?
I don't know about the story with Tim Sylvia about fifth match. I don't know if people want to see, maybe, but we like, you know, no more bullshit between me and Tim. We talked after the fight, you know, he's the best guy. I wish him all the best in his life and his MMA career. About my fight against Devin Cole, yeah, I absolutely agree with him. What he said, that World Series of Fighting doesn't want to give me somebody because of my previous name, because of I was UFC heavyweight champion. Definitely it's going to be tough fight for me. And like I said, I saw the Devin Cole fights. He's a tough fighter. He's all the time coming forward, you know, he's never back down, and I'm very excited. Like I said, it's going to be another big test for me, and I'm looking forward. I'm very excited.
Looking forward to it as well. Thank you, Andre. And my final question is to Ray. You fought as recently as March of this year, going all the way to a decision with Mirko Krokop. Now, you're obviously the president of World Series of Fighting, but being around all these fighters, do you feel you're going to have the itch to have one more fight?
No, I haven't retired yet. I'm still looking to do 7 more fights. I've had 93 pro fights, and I want to do 7 more to reach 100 and then look at retiring.
Excellent. So you feel that you'll be able to devote full time to being president of the World Series fighter and continue fighting?
Absolutely. I got itchy feet right now. I mean, just looking at the crowd and listening to, you know, Devin Cole, Andre Arlovski, you know, Anthony and Linderman. I mean, like, I wish I was fighting on the night, but, you know, it is what it is. And when you're a fighter, you're always going to be a fighter. It's just a matter of understanding when that time comes to stop. I'm not ready to stop yet. I still feel I'm in great shape. I train 6 days a week, twice a day. So I love what I do, and I enjoy it. So matter of fact, I have a fight scheduled looking at New Year's Eve in Japan in December.
All right. Well, who will you be fighting on that day?
I'm not sure yet. I was just sent the email yesterday to receive my availabilities, and I said yes. And so I think I will hear back from them in the next couple of days. And then everybody will know, I guess.
All right. Well, we look forward to hearing about that fight, and we look forward to the World Series of Fighting. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
There are no more questions in queue.
Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for participating in today's conference call. And again, if you have any further questions down the road, please feel free to reach out to Mike or myself. And again, thank you for participation, and hope you can all attend or view the card here in Las Vegas, November 3. Again, our thanks.
That concludes today's conference call. You may now disconnect your lines.